Good evening, everyone. I'm just having this conversation with my friend today morning about who deserves the honor of being the best actor of this year. So as I was having the conversation over the tech, I made sure I would use the right yellow faces and right red faces to make my conversation more meaningful. I don't know what you are having in mind, so I'll show you the illustrations. We all are very familiar with this set of illustrations, the emoticons. So we use it every single day, and these are the fundamental emoticons which you use to let the other person know how you're feeling. So have you ever noticed the intricate detailing done behind them? So I'll just show you a close-up of one of the emoticons. So this is a red heart emoticon which we find in the average WhatsApp emoji keyboard. We all thought it was red, but we hadn't ever noted that there was a predominantly white gradient, which looks like something unusual. I mean, just look at it. And we hadn't ever noticed it. So this leaves us a thought that so many illustrations which are around us have been gone unnoticed. I'm an illustrator. I illustrate things, or to put it into simpler words, I design things or I draw things which involves a technique which is an equal mixture of technology and art. So I believe technology has ruled our life so much that the traditional form of painting, like where we had the plant extracted paints and bony head brushes, have been replaced by a stylus and a graphic tablet. So this is the illustrator which is designing or illustrating on the modern device. That's a stylus and a Wacom graphic tablet. I'm not doing any branding here, so I'll just call it a graphic tablet. So this is the technique we employ to make the illustrations in this modern era. I'm in my third year of engineering, and as an engineering student, I believe technology is a construct which is derived from mathematical dimensions. It's derived from mathematical dimensions, and it seeks problems and it provides solutions and makes things very simpler. Now, this is what I believe technology is. And on the other hand, I see art as a raw expression of an artist's feelings. So I believe the genius conglomeration of art and technology in today's world have made me what I am today. So technology has all its aspects in this art, in the field of art, and as I told, the conglomeration of technology and art has been taken over, and it has led to a modern era of illustrations. Nonetheless, whatever I do, I begin with a very, very basic sketch before I start to illustrate something. So this is a very, very basic sketch where I begin a comic strip or a cartoon or an illustration which that I can call an illustration in my words. So I believe this is a very, very rough scribble done with a pencil and a paper. I'm sure many of you over here might have done something like this on the last page of your notebook, thanks to the boring lectures. So this is the very basic thing. There is no involvement of technology over here. So if you're wondering like what you're talking about illustrations, how am I even related to this? Like, if you want a neat connection for the illustrations to your life, you might have been very familiar with the Google doodles, which you see every single day. Even today, the Google's homepage has been updated with a Shakespeare doodle in the memoir of Shakespeare. So the people behind the Google doodles, behind the wonderfully detailed Google doodles, are illustrators. So we don't even give a thought about how the doodles are made. So these are the amazing. This is one of my favorite Google doodles. This was done with the Lito Martina of 2015. So this is where you can see the exact or a very uniform mixture of art and technology to bring a very modern art. So it brings happiness, or it brings triggers happiness in the audience. So I'll go back to the scribble, rough scribble, and I'll show you the steps or series of steps where a rough scribble can be converted into a proper illustration in the terms of an illustrator. So this one is made to this. This is done on the digital media. The outline of skin. Then it's given some colors, then some lights and shades. And then you have a boy and a dog. So the repeated procedures of doing this, or repeated procedures of illustrating this, leads you to more and more better illustrations. Or see, I have drawn just a boy and a dog. So more procedures give me more people. And then again, the repeated procedures give me lots of people like this. If you realize that if you are thinking where the dog went, it's somewhere on Mr. Crow. So I'm just saying how the digital media have facilitated the illustrators to bring a modern art like this. This is not something new I'm showing you. This is the type of art which is being employed in the comics we read. We have been reading comics since the childhood. I've been reading comics since my childhood, and I read them even now. The only difference between me reading comics back then and now is I do a lot of observing of comics now. I study the anatomy of characters, how the characters are placed, and the very interesting part of a comic is, if a guy in a comic has long nose in the frame, he has to continue to have a long nose throughout the story. That is the privilege of the illustrator to keep the comics consistent. I mean, not many people dip into the details of a character's nose, but it is the privilege of an illustrator, and it is the minute detailing, it's the intricate detailing we employ while making a comic. So, moving on, we have a lot of applications of illustrations which we see in our everyday life. When I started out as an artist, as I said you before, I've been drawing since I was a child, and I've been successful in converting my childhood hobby of doodling, to a profession of being an illustrator. So, like many of you, I told you, like, you might have drawn some scribbling on your last page of your notebook, and your lecture might have even implicated you, like, you know, you'll never lead a successful life if you continue to do the same thing. Okay, I lead a life by doing those things. I mean, how unsuccessful is my life? You know, like, that is the ridiculous part of my life, you know. I've been doing the same nuisance since I was in school, and I'm standing here to talk about those things. I used to draw my friends and teachers at school, and, you know, they were pretty happy. And I do the same thing even now. I mean, not the friends and teachers, I draw caricatures of people. And people frame it and take it to home, and they keep it in their house. And they send me pictures of it, you know, thank you so much for making my room look beautiful, or something like that. You know, that is the same happiness, to a greater extent, I have received so far. So when I started out as an artist, I absolutely had nobody to mentor me, or, you know, to tell you have to do this. Actually, in fact, I didn't even know there was actually a profession called an illustrator. I thought, okay, some people can't design and just go. I didn't even know there was a distinct profession called an illustrator. Nonetheless, there is this one teacher whom I have to owe all my gratitude to. To have making me what I am today. Yes. So this is the one I know which taught me everything. I had nothing when I thought I had to be an illustrator to do something in the design field. All I had was my device, 60 kbps of internet, and my incredible passion of becoming a designer. So trying to illustrate or learning to illustrate wasn't a cakewalk at all. I didn't know where to begin from. I was in my engineering, trying to save up my grades, trying to concentrate more on my academics. And it has been over 2.5 years since I am doing this job, and it has brought me immense happiness. So recently I have been to a design event at Google. I was invited to Google Bangalore to attend a design event. There I was accompanied by a lot of designers who act like actual UI UX designers, virtual artists from who work for another company, and they asked me, "What do I do?" I told them, "I'm an engineering, third year engineering." They're like, "What?
you are in your engineering, you're supposed to be, you know, concentrating more on saving your CGPA and, you know, thinking how to get place in company. Like, what are you doing over here? I mean, what are you even doing in your life, like with the dinner and everything? I mean, I didn't have an answer for them then, but I'm just happy that I'm doing what I love. You know, that is the thing which gets me immense happiness by doing this. There was one day, I believe it was Women's Day, yeah? I was just going to my Facebook newsfeed, and one of the artists whom I follow, she had shared a link of, you know, top 150 artists from India and all something like that. I went to the link, I saw some 8 to 9 artists. I was pretty happy, okay, these artists I knew them. I just saw 8 to 9 of one among 150 artists. I closed the link. That one thing put me to deep thoughts. I have been doing the design thing since 2 years. And you know, what did I even get? Okay, I do a lot of projects, so many projects keep coming to me. I used to design for my friend's startups and all those stuff. You know, if my friend had written a book and he wanted to me to design a cover page of that, I used to do that. But ultimately, what have I even found? So that one afternoon, I couldn't even sleep. Like, I that put me to really very, very deep thoughts. You know, what am I doing? Like, at the same time, I had even killed all my graves. I had so many backlogs, and I was like, okay, I think this is the time to quit my profession of being an illustrator. That is me, by the way. So, I had finally done that. You know, till then, that I hadn't realized I had become an illustrator. So things, days rolled on, projects started coming my way. So many people started giving me projects, like, can you do that for me? So many things came up, and I kept all my engineering aside and I started concentrating on this. And as a result, I killed my engineering. I had so many backlogs and I'm still trying to cover up all those things. So this is, but still I don't regret. You know, I'm doing something which I love. I've not flunked in engineering just because, you know, I wasted my time or spent my time doing something like what unusual or, you know, something like wasting time. So I am an independent illustrator. I call myself independent because, you know, I learn everything by myself. If you are if you graduate from engineering today, there are some 10 to 15 lecturers who have helped you throughout, I mean, all your 4 years to have made your engineering graduate. You have made me an illustrator. I was the only one. I mean, I taught myself everything. So I call myself an independent illustrator. I totally think that I do. So all throughout these 2 years, I had attended so many events. I talked so, like, at many places, and, you know, so many. I mean, my design is appreciated at so many places. All throughout, the technology was with me. I was very, very bad at a traditional form of art. I didn't know how to paint a thing on a paper with using the brush and the poster colors. Whereas I can do a similar thing on the digital media very easily. So I can tell that the digital media have facilitated me so much. So I can tell the conglomeration of technology and art have completely made me what I am today. Success for me is not the money I earn. Success for me is not the appreciation I receive from my clients. Success for me is the happiness I see on the people's face when I you know, do something for them. I had a friend. It was just 2 days away from Valentine's Day. So he was like, dude, I don't know what to give to my girlfriend. Do something to me, you know. So I thought, okay, I'm an illustrator. I can do something for him. Then I told, like, okay, you just give me a explanation of a situation of you both, like, which you cannot forget at all. Then he gave me a small situation and I just started to sketch it like that. He gave me the intricate details of every single thing. What he wore, what posture did she was standing, what footwear she wore, everything. And I managed to sketch it out and that came really brilliant. Just for that. And he would love to get it to you. He got it printed and gave it to his girlfriend, and she was almost in tears. You know, she was like, "That girl is way too prettier than me, man." You know,
it is like that. The things like this have made me successful today. So I can tell that the mixture of art and technology has made a way to trigger people's positivity or trigger people's happiness. It's like this. So I shall get back to the, you know, the sustenance of art and technology. So everybody might have seen this painting. It is Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh. This is a very remarkable artwork the people have, I mean, the painters, the ancient times have ever given us. So this is a very neat example I can give you where the art has sustained without even a touch of technology. It's a cleanly traditional painting which Vincent has done. So let us have a look. How does this painting look when it is given a spin of technology? So it's like, it looks like this. Probably Vincent van Gogh would have been happier to see this. So this is the artist here has extracted layers from the copies of the picture, added some spin, and there you have this. So I can tell, and the thing to note is that the nature, I mean, you know, the the nature of the painting has not been altered. You can see that, but it has just given it is just given a spin, and you have a Starry Night of today's era. So this is how I tell the art and technology has managed to mix up really, like, fundamentally together well and brought out a modern art for us. So art is everywhere around us, and even afternoon you had lunch, even you could, if you had noticed the box, even those are called illustrations. Just go and have a look at those designs which is made on the box. They are called illustrations. Every single detail of them are defined by illustrators. And even the murals on the streets of Bangalore, that is one heck of a work to do. But, you know, it seems so simple. And even the emoticons and all those stuff. So just start noticing the illustrations around you, because I believe art makes life beautiful. Thank you.